All right, let's talk about the different task queues and start off with the push queue, which is the most common one. The execution of push queues are managed by App Engine itself. This means that App Engine has worker threads that scan these queues and pick up tasks. These threads then call a URL that you have specified when you insert the task in the queue. This means that the execution is broken out from the HTTP request response flow, since App Engine provides the threads to execute the tasks. But the code used to process each task is still provided by you, since you provide the URL that the worker threads call. The best of two worlds, a generic execution methodology that works with code that you write. So the worker thread picks up task by task and calls your URL for each of them. And this behavior continues for all the tasks in the queue until the queue is empty. By default, the maximum execution duration for a task is 10 minutes. It is of course up to you when you develop the application to split up the work into tasks that can be completed within this time, for example 100 mails each. There are many different configuration options for queues. In the following screen, we will look at some of them. First to note is that queues are defined in a queue configuration file when you do development. All queues have a queue name. For all applications, App Engine already provides a default queue with the name default. This queue can be used without adding anything to the queue configuration file, but you may want to change its default options, in which case you need to define it in the file. Other things you can configure are the performance parameters, such as the rate of processing, the maximum rate in case of traffic peaks, the bucket size, and the maximum number of concurrent tasks that can be executed. There are also a lot of parameters surrounding error management. So now we've talked about how to define a queue. Let's finish this part by looking at how to create a task and assign it to a queue for execution. The first thing you do is get the queue by the queue name. Then you create the task and set options such as the task name, the URL to process the task, and other parameters such as performance and retry options. And finally, you add the task to the queue for execution. Finally, it is important that you protect the URL so only administrators can access them through the permission settings. You don't want external users to be able to execute your task logic should they get a hold of these URLs. That was a lot of theory, but that's it for now. Now the time has come for you to do some work, because we have an exercise coming up where you will use push queues. Good luck!